In this illustration, we'll study about the conduction in a cylindrical space. Here we are given that the space between two long coaxial cylindrical surfaces is filled with a homogeneous isotropic substance, and the radii of surfaces are R1 and R2. And in a steady state, the temperature of inside and outside surfaces are T1 and T2, with the outside surface at higher temperature. And we are required to find the inside temperature of material at a distance R from the axis. Here, for the sake of clarity, here we can draw the picture. This here cylindrical substance, of which the outer radii is R2, and this is the inner cylindrical zone, which is of radii R1. If this is the axis of cylinder, we can see the inner radius is R1 and the outer radius of the cylinder is R2. And the material inside we assume is of thermal conductivity, say K. The length of this cylindrical region is given to us as L. Now, in the situation we are given inside temperature is T1, outside is T2, with outside temperature at a higher value. So, heat will be conducted in radially inward direction from the surrounding. So, temperature also varies from inside to outside region. And to analyze it, first we'll calculate the rate of flow of heat, for which we need to find the total thermal resistance. Here, we consider at a distance x, a small elemental shell, cylindrical shell, or within this volume, which is of width dx, like this. This is a hollow cylinder, I am assuming, of same length L, but it is of radius x. And the width of this hollow cylindrical shell we can consider as dx. So here we can write thermal resistance of elemental shell is, this we can write as dr. The value of dr will be 1 by k, and the heat which will flow across it in a width dx, this dx divided by the area is 2 pi xl. And if you wish to calculate the total thermal resistance, of cylinder is, the cylindrical medium through which the heat is flowing is R thermal, we can write as 1 by k, this is integration of dx upon 2 pi xl, and we integrate it from R1 to R2 as x is varying from R1 to R2. And in this situation, this gives us 1 by 2 pi k L multiplied by, it is 1 by x dx integration. So this will be ln of R2 by R1. And similarly, if we calculate the thermal resistance for the inner region from R1 to x, or any value R, we can also calculate here the thermal resistance of material from R1 to small r, where small r is any distance which is greater than R1 but less than R2 within the material of the cylinder. So this resistance we can write as R, which is from R1 to R, can be given as the same value will integrate 1 by k integration from R1 to R, this dx upon 2 pi xl, which on integration gives 1 by 2 pi k L ln of R by R1. Now, as we are having the resistance from R1 to R, and for the whole cylindrical region the resistance from R1 to R2, we can say in a steady state, here we can write dq by dt, the rate of heat conduction from R1 to R2 must be same as dQ by dt from R1 to R. So in this situation, if we carry on here, we just use the same from R1 to R2 heat conduction rate is T2 minus T1 divided by the thermal resistance, which is 1 upon 2 pi k L ln of R2 by R1. This should be equals to the conduction rate from R1 to R. So if at a point R we consider temperature is T, then we can write it T minus T1 divided by 1 by 2 pi k L ln of R by R1. Here this 2 pi k L gets cancelled out. And on simplifying this value, we can get the value of temperature as a function of distance R, or this is the value of temperature at a distance R from the axis, can be given by T1 plus this T2 minus T1 multiplied by ln of R by R1 divided by ln of R2 by R1. This is the result of this problem.